So three things you should set up very early on in your playthrough is the Reap Shuttle, the Fuel Shuttle, and a TUG ship. These are LitCube's universe features that allow you to automate and make salvaging much easier, along with refueling. So early on in the game, you'll probably notice that as you destroy ships, or as they die to NPCs, they drop loot, such as shields and weapons. For example, all of these crates here in Rebel Sector M148. Now, the chance that a ship drops loot increases with your fight rank. So, if, as you can see here, at max combat rank, extreme, the freight loot chance is 25%. So for each weapon and shield or whatever on a ship, enemy ship, when a player-owned ship destroys it, it has a 25.97 chance of dropping. That is huge. If you clear out an entire sector in a massive battle with a player-owned MLCC fleet, there are going to be hundreds of loot containers. So to pick up a loot container, all you need to do is just fly your ship into said container. And that is like the easiest way to start making money in the early game. Now, that is very tedious, so another thing you can do is put special command software, which is this upgrade right here, on a ship of yours. It doesn't have to be a transport, it can be a fighter or anything, and give it the command special collect wares in sector. Your ship will proceed to fly into all of the containers in a sector and just pick them up. And therefore, you can be doing something better with your time while one of your ship cleans up your mess. And you'll have all of the missiles and things in the ship. Now, in LitCube's universe, that command has been enhanced with the ability to use a transporter device. Transporter device will allow the ship collecting wares to pick up containers from a distance of up to 5 kilometers rather than having to physically fly into them. So this will greatly increase the effectiveness of that command. So if you have a transporter device, go to special and collect wares in sector, it will get them done much faster. So a Reap Shuttle is a special designation you can give to one of these salvage ships. And again, it can be a capital ship, it can be a TL, it doesn't matter. I like TS ships because they're very cheap, very easy to get early on in the game, and they have a good cargo bay to carry back a whole sector full of loot. So anyway, it's a designation you can give to one of your ships that allows it to do this remotely with hotkeys. And you can do it from the satellite monitoring menu as well, which is very efficient. So all you need is a station. You don't need a station to do it manually, just giving it the collect wares and sector command, but to do a Reap Shuttle, you're going to need a station. So I have an XQ2 platform built here in the background. All it does is it has energy cells, and I have a dock agent automatically stocking this with energy cells up to 10,000, so the ship's home base here can use it as refuel. I'm not going to cover that. Again, that's a very in-depth topic, and I'm going to need a separate tutorial for that. But anyway, say you have like a Saturn complex hub producing a bunch of extra energy cells, you can easily set up a courier to deliver it to a station. And if you're really cheap, you can always share a mobile mining station with the Reap Shuttle. It doesn't need its own station. I'm just doing that here in the example. You can easily home base the Reaper Shuttle at any other base. It doesn't really matter. The base is just where the shuttle is going to refuel and bring back all of the cargo it collects. So, I'm going to get this ship. It's going to need the following upgrades. I'm not entirely sure if, I mean, some of them are not obviously needed, like boost extension and duplex scanner, but you're going to need a transporter device, special command, and a jump drive, obviously. So I'm going to give it a home base, the XQ2 platform right here. I'm going to send it back home. So this GR75 that I'm going to be using as the Reap Shuttle, it doesn't need any special commands because the commands are handled through the menu. So all I'm going to do is actually just rename it so I know it's the Reap Shuttle, and I'm just going to give it a prefix like that. Another thing I like to do is recolor the ship name to yellow. That's not yellow. Yellow. So it appears official in the property list, so I know not to mess with that ship. And if you go into the game's controls, you will see that there are hotkeys for Quickshuttle Reap Go and Quickshuttle Reap Home. This is how you call the ship into your sector to collect loot. Now, before we do that, we have to register the Reap Shuttle. So open LitCube's player console. That's done with another hotkey. Go to Quickshuttles. So here is where we designate a ship as the Reap Shuttle. We need to toggle Reap Shuttle as opposed to Fuel Shuttle and find the ship we want to designate. So our ship is a TS, Reap Gallifrey Transport, hit enter, and it is now designated. So we can send the Reap Shuttle to collect wares. So let's go do that. Let's find a sector that has wares we can loot. So let's see. Black Hole Sun. In Black Hole Sun, there is two Wasp Missiles and 2 5 Megajoule Shields. So we can go to Black Hole Sun and press our button to bring in the Reap Shuttle, and it will jump in and collect the wares, and then we can press our Go Home button, and it will jump out. Another thing you can do is you can hit the Jump Home button at any time, even interrupting the command. So say it jumps into a sector like the aforementioned Rebel Sector M14A, which is crawling with pirates because of reasons, and it's in danger. You can just press the Reap Shuttle Home button at any time, and it will jump out of that sector. That's a good sector to use to demonstrate. Another thing you can do is remotely send it. So in the satellite monitoring menu, you can find the sector you want. So let's see, Rebel Sector M148, right here. And this also lists all the wares in the sector. So the first number is how many unique wares are in that sector. The second number is how many total wares. So if there was one, so let's look at this one right here, 1 and 3. So there's one unique ware, just the Windstalker missile, but there's 3 of them. So that's what these numbers mean. So right now, satellite monitoring is on view sector. If we change this to send the Reaper, and then we click on Rebel Sector M148, you'll hear command accepted, and your Reap Shuttle, if you can look here, it doesn't actually show the command, but it should jump out in a second. Now this could also be done by going to the sector and pressing the button to call it in. That just calls it into the same sector the player is in. And here it is. It's in the sector, it's picking up all the boxes, it got all the ones in the middle, and it's going to go around and collect all the other ones. So it's going for this one right now. What is this? Impulse ray emitters. Once it gets within transporter device range, it will pick it up and go to the next one. So let's see. Yep, it picked it up. And because I have... So here's a trick, actually. If you go to the jump drive settings and you set it to 0, so say this box down here, when he's ready to pick it up, he's just going to jump to the south gate and go pick it up. And he will use the gates in the sector to do that. It's much quicker and more efficient. Looks like the Rebels beat all the pirates, so we don't have to worry about sending him home early. He's going to pick up this crate right now, and then after he picks this one up, he should go down here and pick that one up. And there he is at the south gate. And if you look at his cargo, here's all the loot he's been picking up. So you'll get a message. Unfortunately, mine is glitched. As I said, I've been messing with this game far too much. I've destroyed the files. But yours should have a list of everything that the ship has looted. And he will just return home and drop it off. I don't know where he is. Let's see. So here's our Reap Shuttle. It will come and drop off all of the loot it just picked up in that sector. And we should be able to see that in the station's inventory. So if we open the station's inventory, we should see all of the loot it picked up. Yep, and there's all the loot it picked up. That's actually quite a bit of money early on in the game. And all we have to do now is just open satellite monitoring and find another sector. 206, what's this? It's just energy cells. Black Hole Sun, that's decent. Just send the Reaper. I mean, it doesn't cost you anything to do that. Just might as well just go loot everything all the time. And this is another good reason to get a very good satellite network up, so you have access to all of this information. And like I said before, if you want to just call into your current sector, there's a hotkey for that, and you can just press that. Looks like he already got all the loot and is already on the way back. So anyway, that's the Reap Shuttle. So the next thing to set up is called a Fuel Shuttle, and this actually isn't as important as the Reap Shuttle. All it does is you press a button, and it brings energy cells to the player ship. So Say I'm floating around in this giant assault frigate Mark II that I have here. It's not very convenient for me to go dock at a shipyard to get more energy cells, and I can't just dock at solar power plants. So if I ever run out, I can just press a button and the fuel shuttle will come bring more energy cells to me. So again, all you need is a TS ship. Of course, this doesn't have to be a TS. You can make it a battleship if you want. So you can abuse this and call in a battleship at the press of a button, but it's still just going to refuel you. So we just have a cheap TS we found, YT-1760. You just need the standard equipment here, transporter device, so it can beam the cargo to you. So this one's important, supply command software. You can't just buy this at most equipment docks. It's, I think what this does is it lets a ship resupply missiles and fuel to a whole fleet or something. I don't know, I've never actually used it because MLCC makes it obsolete. Or something like that. I don't know, I've never used it, but you need supply command software and then navigation and jump drive as always. So another thing is set the jump supply, resupply to standard as well. Home base it to any station that has energy cells. So my station, as I said before, this XT2 platform has a dock agent working for it that just brings it energy cells and keeps it topped off at 10,000. And I'm not going to go over how to set that up again here because it's a very in-depth topic, the dockware manager. You can also, unlike the Reap Shuttle, you don't need a station that has an inventory like this where you can drop off anywheres. You can just base this at a Saturn Complex Hub or any other place that just produces energy cells. It doesn't have to be a trade station like the Reaper Shuttle needs. You can't base the Reaper Shuttle on a Saturn Complex Hub because a Saturn Complex Hub can't. It doesn't have the inventory to pick up weapons and stuff like this because it's a factory. So anyway, I'm going to home base the YT-1760 there. I'm just going to send it home. Let's see. Return home. And I'm going to name it, give it the same prefix, so fuel. And I'm going to color the name yellow just so I know not to accidentally tell it to do something else. So here it is, the fuel shuttle, and then in the player console, back to quick shuttles, toggle over to fuel shuttle and select the one you need. I did this a second ago, so that's why it was already yellow. So now that we've specified the fuel shuttle, all we need to do is run ourselves out of energy, and it should be able to resupply our player ship. So I'm going to wait for it to go and dock up at the at its home base. And I am going to eject all of my ship's energy cells. So my assault frigate now is out of gas if I try to jump. Can't, out of fuel. And the amount it will resupply you, so this is my assault frigate's command console, right here, fuel resupply jump. So if I were to dock at a station that sold energy cells with my assault frigate, it would automatically buy this many energy cells, fuel resupply. That's how all my other ships work. But we, as we specified earlier, that's not practical to do because these ships are too big and slow. So I can just press the fuel quick shuttle button, which we specify in the controls menu. You'll hear command accepted, and the ship will jump to us with energy cells, and it will refuel us. So there it is. We check its cargo bay. It is full of energy cells. Now, important, you may think, because it's the fuel shuttle, you just want to set this to like 500 or something maxed out so it's full of energy cells. These energy cells are treated differently. That is the ship's fuel. So if you set this to like 200, all that fuel for 200 jumps will be off limits for refueling. So that's why I set it to the standard 50. It'll automatically fill up its cargo and come bring me the energy cell. So anyway, what you just saw there in the background, the ship jumped to the center of the sector, it flew down to me, and it beamed the energy cells aboard. So if I check my cargo, I have energy cells, as I specified, and I think the reason I don't have the full 2,000 that I need for 100 jumps is because the fuel shuttle is a YT-1760, which is a very cheap and terrible freighter that doesn't have a lot of cargo capacity, so it just couldn't bring me all of them, but that's fine. I have enough to keep me going for quite a while. And then whenever I run out of fuel, I can just press the button and it will come jump to me again and bring me fuel. And that's pretty much all there is to the fuel shuttle. It's very basic. All right, and the last subject is the TUG ship. Now, this is not a quick shuttle like the others. It is any ship that can carry, that can dock other ships with it. So my assault frigate here would actually work as well. But starting out, a TM ship like a VCX or a Gazanti Vanguard are probably better options. You can also use any M6 that can carry things like a Carillion Corvette or a Imperial Raider Corvette. Those can carry fighters or all the way up to a TL. The catch is it needs a home base that can dock, that it can dock with. So early on in the game, you're probably not going to have a station that can dock a capital ship like a TL that can carry medium ships. So you'll only be able to automate salvaging fighters early on. So anyway, here's a VCX in our other sector with the XQ2 platform in 2 grand. I am going to set its home base to the XQ2 platform. Again, this doesn't matter, but I like having this as the same home base as the Reap shuttle. Auto jump settings, standard 50, auto jump, yes. And it doesn't really need weapons, but you can give it weapons anyway. And for software, you just need standard things. I don't think you actually need the transporter device, but I just bought it anyway. So you should be able to go to special and see TUG. If it's grayed out, that means you haven't set the home base yet, or you don't have enough software. So make sure to check both of those things. And as always, the home base just needs to be any dock station that has energy cells that it can use for refuel. And I have the dock agent automatically resupplying this station with energy cells. Don't use a Saturn complex hub because it needs to be able to hold loot. So I'm going to name the ship. I'm going to give it the prefix so I know it's a TUG ship and I shouldn't accidentally think it's a different type of ship. Color ship name. And I will just send it home. Or in fact, I will give it the command. So special and TUG. So what the TUG ship does is any ship you own, it will bring it back to base. And it can actually strip the cargo as well. So say you find an abandoned Delta 7. Those are always, you'll always find a bunch of those. They're pretty garbage. They make good explorers, but you will just find so many of them. And most likely, you will go claim it, and then you will go tell it to dock at the nearest shipguard. You will forget it for probably an hour or so, and then you'll be like, why do I have a Delta 7 in the middle of nowhere? Or you might sell it or something, and it's hard to keep track of. The TUG ship, what it does is, the second you claim that Delta 7, you can just call in the flag the ship for TUG, and the TUG ship will see that, and it will bring the Delta 7 back. Now it can bring it back and just leave it at the base, or it can bring it back and remove all of its equipment and put all of that equipment in the base's inventory, in the station's inventory. So that's what strip functionality means. If you want the ship to just bring the salvaged fighters back and just drop them off at the base so you can have them all in one place, so you can come repair them all at once and not have to worry about buying them jump drives and bringing them across the universe to all meet in one location, that's fine. You just leave this as none, and then you hit TUG. If you want the ship, your TUG ship, to bring the ships back and then remove all of their inventory and put that in the station's inventory and just leave the empty ship sitting at the base, you leave this at home base. And if you want the TUG ship to remove all of the salvage ship's cargo and put it in the TUG ship's inventory, so say you don't have a base, or actually I'm not sure if this works without a base, but this will put all the loot in the TUG ship's inventory. So I'm going to use at home base, and I'm going to issue the TUG command. So you should just see the ship in the command menu saying just TUG, and it will say TUG returning home, TUG whatever. As long as it says TUG something, you're good. You don't have to worry about this ship. Just don't touch it. Let it do its thing. So the next step is to find an abandoned ship. So using the trusty satellite monitoring, let's see. Home of Light has 2 abandoned ships. We got a Dune Lizard and a Delta 7 near the south gate. So I'm going to head over there. Wrong sector. South gate. And I'm going to go claim those ships.
Entering system, home.
And I am not flying this assault frigate over there, so I am going to launch my X-Wing. And go claim the ships. There's a button you can set in the controls to just automatically target the nearest unclaimed ship. In this case, I've set it to O on my keyboard, so if I press that, it automatically targeted the Doom Lizard, and I can go over there and claim it. Now, I have the very expensive upgrade for remote system control software, so I don't even have to get out of my... I don't even have to get out of my ship to claim the other ships. So anyway, what you typically do in a situation like this is you get out, you repair them, you send them to a shipyard, and you sell them. Or you send them to a shipyard, put a jump drive on them, and then you send them back to your base, which in my case is here in Tugrand, which is across the galaxy. I can't just send them there because to get to Tugrand from Home of Light, they have to fly through the pirate, this is what's known as the Pirate Highway. These sectors right here. They're not going to make it. So instead of sending them to Argon Prime and getting the jump drives and all that, we're just going to have our TUG ship take them back to Tugrand. So there's a hotkey you can set in the controls to flag for TUG. So I'm going to hit that now. So you'll see the Doom Lizard's name has changed to Doom Lizard Flagged TUG. And that's all you have to do. Another thing you can do is you can go into the ship's command console, additional ship commands, flag for TUG. It's much easier, though. I mean, you can do that if you have ships like in sectors the player's not in, but if you're in the same sector as the ship, just target it and hit the hotkey and flag it for TUG. And that's it. Now the ship will be at your base, and it will either be stripped or not stripped based on how you set the TUG ship. So here comes our VCX automatically. It will just constantly be checking for any ships with flagged TUG on it, and it will go get them. So the VCX will approach the ships, and it will actually dock the ships with them. You don't have to give any commands other than the flag. So let's see. It's got the A-Wing, and it's got the Dune Lizard on the side, and it's going to go take them back to Tugrand. And we don't really have to worry about it. So if we go look at Tugrand, our VCX is returning to its base, the XQ2 platform, and it will drop off those ships. So I have it. I have strip set to true. So engine noises. So it will name the ships stripped after they've been stripped. So. The final result is you just have these empty ships stripped. If we look at their cargo, all of their goods are empty. The upgrades are still there, but all of the goods are empty. So you can do whatever you want with these ships now. They're all in one location. So you can put together a scrappy wing of fighters. You pretty much have to do this in Mayhem in the early game, but you can sell them. But this is actually better because in the station now, in addition to what the Reap Shuttle has been collecting, all of the equipment that those ships had will be at the station. So you can have dock agents automatically selling these for the best price. And this is far superior to just selling the ship. So by removing all the equipment, we've reduced the value of the ship. But the way it works is when you sell a ship, whatever is in its cargo, upgrades, goods, weapons, whatever, those will only add half of their value to the ship. So say I have a gun that is 100,000 credits on that ship. It will only add 50,000 to the sale price of the ship. So by doing this, I can sell the gun for its full 100,000 and then sell the ship. So you'll be getting more money this way. And it's just another good way to just have this station full of everything. So say you're at war with the Empire, and you don't have a good way to buy Imperial guns, but you're producing Imperial ships at your own station. You'll have this giant repository of weapons here and loot that you've collected from across the galaxy, and you'll probably have some there. So you'll have your own equipment dock that you can just come and get all of these goods from. You can use them, you can sell them, yeah, you can pretty much do whatever you need with them. And you don't have to worry about the logistics of taking the ships across the galaxy, because the TUG ship did it for you. Now, the TUG ship can be a TL, it can be a capital ship, it can be whatever. So if I find an abandoned, like, transport, a TS ship, or an abandoned, M6, I think there's one here. So yeah, here's an abandoned Hammerhead Corvette. I can't actually flag, well, I can flag it for TUG, but nothing's going to happen, because the VCX I'm using as a TUG ship can't dock a ship the size of the Hammerhead Corvette with it. So I would need a bigger tug ship that could carry that. But in the early game, a VCX is a great choice for all of those fighters. I can definitely get these two Delta 7s with the tug ship. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. Automatic salvaging with the tug ship, the Reaper shuttle, and also refueling with the Quickshuttle.